the circle, and Brett Hartnell shot, scores! Scott Hartnell on a second power play opportunity. Another great pass by Giroux out of the left wing corner. And a third attempt, leaping in the air. Giroux in front of Hartnell with a shot, he scores! And Scott Hartnell's got his second of the period. This one, even strength. Giroux in front, Hartnell shot, scores! His sixth career hat trick for Scott Hartnell. Two of the three today on the power play. And as the hats rain down, the Flyers take the 4-3 lead.
Talked about him a lot today. He is on a roll. The Flyers' Scott Hartnell now joins us on the phone. Scott, thanks so much for your time. How are you today?
I'm great, thanks. How are you guys doing?
Appreciate your time. All right, so tell us about this role. Natural hat trick yesterday. Two goals Saturday. You got 25 goals for the year, and your career high for a single season is 30. What has made you so good so far?
I don't know. It's been a good, obviously, season so far. We've been doing well as a team, which makes everything a lot better. But playing with Jágr and Drew is not a bad thing either. They're terrific players. They cannot do almost anything with the puck, and I was just able to get on that line, and we were able to find success right away, and it's kind of continued throughout the whole year.
I'll tell you, I watched that game yesterday against the Bruins. That was an entertaining game you guys played with him, and you were right in the middle of it, obviously, with the natural hat trick in the second period. A natural hat trick, I mean, it's not something we see every day. Have you ever had one of those before?
I think I had one a few years back against the Islanders. Not that I'm counting or whatever, but
hey, I would count them if you have a natural hat trick. I mean, like I say, they don't come along every day. We don't see them all the time, so I mean, it must be something special. Do you feel like when you get two in a row that you're on a little bit of a roll?
Yeah, you just want to throw everything at the net, and I think I had nine shots last game, and good things happen. You throw the puck to the net, you go to the net, and was able to get some nice shots in the slot, and not every time you're going to beat the goalie, but was able to put a couple home there.
Some shots here, Scott, as we take a look at your highlights from yesterday. Your dad in the stands. What was that like to have him there and play so well at the same time?
Sorry, I missed that. What was that?
Having your dad there you're playing so well there, yeah.
Yeah, sorry. It was awesome to have him. He was in town Friday and Saturday, so he's seen a couple great games. And it was they showed a clip of him high-fiving the other dads up in the suite there. And that building was awesome. Like you said, it was a very entertaining game. There were some big hits. There was some big fights. A lot of goals, a lot of action. And unfortunately, the only downer was we didn't get the 2 points there in shootout.
Hey, Scott, it's funny because with all the, you're a guy that's no stranger to physical play. You were in the middle of things yesterday, and, you put a hit, a hit on Kelly on Boston. And I thought, really, it's one of those videos they could show around the league and say, hey, this is the way you're supposed to do it. You kept your arm down. You threw the shoulder in. I mean, it just was one of those things where he had just had the puck, and, you leveled him. And then it turns into a whole fight scenario there. I mean, what was going on at that moment? Because, I mean, it seems like now sometimes, and the same thing happened to Braden Schenn. He delivered, I thought, a good hit on Kampfer. And again, another fight breaks out. I mean, it seems like you can't deliver a clean hit anymore in this league.
No, I know. And on both those plays, there was no instigator when, two guys clearly go after a guy after they make a, what I think is a clean, obviously legal hard check. And, both instigators were not called there, so I'm not sure what happened there. But yeah, it was the whistle might have blown actually right when I was kind of making contact with him and was already in the process of hitting him, and it was a clean hit, and I kind of saw Thornton drop his gloves and come after me. I was like, oh man, what did I get myself into here? He's a tough cookie. He had a great fight with Jody Shelley there in I think the first period, so I wasn't really expecting that, but just tried to get in there and fell down right away anyway. Hartnell down, so.
Scott, so the All-Star game's upcoming here. You weren't originally picked the roster. There have been some injuries so far. You haven't been added. What's your thought here right now? I don't know if you want to go. I'm sure you would like. Where do you stand on all this?
I'd absolutely love to go. It was, to be considered and, this name be kind of thrown around there in a mix. If in case there's an injury too, I might be there. So it means you're doing some good things on the ice, and your team's having success. So that's obviously a thrill in that respect. And if I did get a call late, definitely I'd drop all plans and head up north across the border. So I, depending on what happens or who gets the call, I'm not too worried about it. But it would be a thrill of a lifetime for sure.
Hey, Scott, I want to ask you a little bit about your relationship with your head coach, Peter Laviolette, because in the 24-7 series, there was a moment where you guys are just skating during practice and you had scored your 200th goal and Peter's skating next to you and he congratulated you on getting to that milestone and then you kind of kidded him back like, well, you know, you never got, you know, how many did you get? And he just said, 12 games, no points. And I just thought that moment between you two guys was telling in some ways that you have a little bit of a relationship there. What is your relationship like with Peter?
I have a lot of respect for him. The way he coaches, the way he approaches, getting guys ready, the game plan and stuff that he has. I think he has a lot of respect for my game. So there's obviously respect in the relationship. But he's a funny guy. He's really intense. Obviously, with all the F-bombs and attitude and stuff like that, he's dropping the show. He's real intense. So obviously that's. I feeds off throughout our team. When your leader like that does that. So, I got to respect a guy like that.
Scott, another concussion for one of your teammates, Danny Briere. The list, it just seems like every time you guys go out there, it's something else, and yet you've been able to remain pretty close to the top of the Eastern Conference. How have you been able to compensate for all these injuries?
Well, 9 rookies that are playing extremely well. I think we had 8 or 9 against Boston, obviously one of the biggest powerhouses in the league, and we fought tooth and nail with them right down to the end. So, guys like Couturier coming in, the 18-year-old kid, and being probably our best penalty killer, all year long. He's got a great stick. Guys bring a lot of energy and attitude, and we're just playing well together. We're having fun, and even though we're winning games, getting points, things like that, when we get JVR and Danny B and Chris Pronger and those guys back from injury, hopefully we just keep on excelling.
Scott, are you worried about the goaltending situation at all?
What do I think about it?
No, you're worried about it at all?
No, not at all. I think both goalies are solid. They both obviously have proven themselves in this league. Bob was our number one last year. Briz has had a great career in Phoenix. Won a Stanley Cup in Anaheim. So I think either one of them in net is a good thing. But I think maybe Briz is lacking about confidence or something like that. You can just kind of tell by the way he's skating around. But I think if we're going to do anything this year and years going forward here, he's going to be an absolutely huge part of that. And we're just excited about him being a Flyer and him in the pipes.
All right, hey Scott, congratulations on your great play so far. Thanks so much for your time. Good luck to you and the Flyers here as you get ready to go after the All-Star break, and hopefully you'll be able to make an appearance in Ottawa. Thanks so much.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks for having me, guys. Appreciate
it. Thanks, Scott.